So friends, once more, welcome to this lecture on the metaphysics of technology. Just like we say, zoology, biology, theology, or philology, archaeology, or anthropology. The word technology contains a complex system of knowledge about man and tools. A complex system of knowledge about man and tools. Just like we say theology. How man and religion related, theology, or zoology, or biology, or philology. So just like that, you know, technology is a complex system of knowledge about man and tools. It talks about how is it formed, where is it used, and what it is. So these types of discussions are being organized when we think about technology. That is, technology is a rational thought system. Technology is a rational thought system. That is a way of doing. That is, if we use simple words, technology means a way of doing or a rational way of doing things. That is technology. So technology implies technique. It implies technique. The technique is the philosophy. Technique is the philosophy. And technology is its manifestation. Technique is the philosophy. And what is then technology? Technology is the manifestation of that technique. That means technology is the metaphysics. Technique is the philosophy governing how tools are being invented, how tools are being used in society, how tools are being upgraded in future. That is called technique. That's a philosophy governing how tools are, how humans create tools. But when it comes to technology, it is the manifestation of that philosophy. That means, in simple words, it is a metaphysics. Technology is a metaphysics. Or put it other words, technology is a complex logic, very complex and also very complicated logic, using so many vocabularies, thereby communicating a specific set of meaning. It uses so many vocabularies, so many linguistic system, thereby tries to communicate a particular way of doing things. So it is a metaphysics about the complex logic governing how machines are being developed in society by humans, how machines are used in society, how machines are updated or upgraded in society. Friends, whenever we use the word technology or technique, you can see that people most often use the word technology or technique. And people automatically assume that, yes, they are talking about machine or tools. Friends, it's a wrong assumption. When we think about, or when we use the word technology or technique, you should never assume that, oh, they are talking about machine or tools. Machine or tools are different from technique or technology. Technology is the metaphysics. The technique is the philosophy. Tools are, you know, the physical reality of that technique. Or machines are the physical reality of that philosophy of technique. For us, machines or tools are analogous to technology. Most ordinary people, including educated people, simply use the word technology just to refer to machines. We commonly think of our world is a world of machines. And in believing so, we think that it's a world of technology. For us, there is no difference between the words machines and technology. So right from the time of Homo habilis, which we have discussed in the previous lecture, Homo habilis, paleanthropologists believe that our world is a world of machine tools. You remember last day we talked about Olduvai Gorge in Tanzania in 1964. The Leakey family discovered something very interesting about human fossils 2.4 million years ago, that they were believed to have used some kind of stone tools. So paleanthropologists, right from the beginning, believe that Homo habilis used tools, therefore Homo sapiens are tool makers. And according to paleanthropologists, our world, that is the Homo sapien world, is a world of tools, machine tools. So their conclusion, that is paleanthropologist conclusion about our ancestors, that is be it Australopithecus or Homo habilis or Homo erectus or Homo Neanderthals, paleanthropologists believe that, or their conclusion is that our ancestors have used tools, and they used tools, or they made tools out of hands. They simply used our hands, these hands, to create tools. They used the hands to create tools. And paleanthropologists believe that tools were created by hands. Friends, do you think that tools were created by hands? But paleanthropologists, including the anthropologist, will tell you that you created tools because of your hand. But friends, modern knowledge or technological studies will tell you something very different. There is a dispute whether hands created tools or whether brain created tools. Interesting question. Whether hands created tools or brain created tools. So this mobile. Whether hands created mobile or the brain created the mobile. It's a very interesting question, friends. So technology studies tell you that throughout all the ages, that is Australopithecus, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Homo Neanderthals, and the latest Homo sapiens. That is throughout all the ages. Man developed tools not by hand, but by what? By brain. And friends, that situation still prevails. Of course, it is correct. Homo habilis created tools perhaps by hand. Maybe there were no connection between their hand and brain. They simply needed tools just as an extension of their body, because they wanted to cut the meat. But it's a disputed fact whether that hand created tool or their brain created the tool. So friends, therefore, we can think in a different way. We can think in a very different way. Machines or the tools is the most obvious massive and impressive example of human technique. Machines are a massive and impressive example of technique. Technique comes from brain. That being stated, technique and tools are different. It's obvious. Technique and tools are different. Techniques begins from brain. Machines belongs to hands or human body. Machines belongs to human body. Technique is our mind, or technology is our mind. Technology is our mind. Whereas machine is product of our hands. We create machine by our hands. Am I correct? We create tools by our hands. But the philosophy governing that machine, which is created by our hands, is a product of technique, which begins from our thought system, that is brain. But friends, when we say the history of technique or technology, right from the time of Homo habilis, we simply assume that it is the history of machines. So there is that terminological puzzle. There's a terminological puzzle in when we use the very word technology. That is, when we think about when man created technology, then we think about the history of, you know, technique. Then we simply assume that right from the time of Homo habilis, men developed tools. So history of technology means the history of machines or tools. We simply think like that. This is, of course, is an example of the very habit of intellectual historians. This is the way intellectual historians of the world present the history of technology to ordinary men. That is, intellectuals regard, it's a very important point, friends, when we think about technology. Intellectuals regard forms of the present as identical with those of the past. It's a very, very technical usage, friends. You think this way. Intellectuals regard forms of the present as identical with those of the past. That is, form in the present correspond to those in the past. Form in the present correspond to those in the past. That is, to put in simple words, tools we had in the early time, or tools we had in the ancient world, tools we had in the Paleolithic age, say our ancestors, Homo habilis or Homo erectus. For the historians, tools we had used since the Paleolithic age are considered same in all ages. But friends, it is a wrong thing to assume so. That is, Homo habilis used tools as an extension of their physical body. Homo habilis used tools as an extension of their physical body. And friends, of course, as I told you in the previous lecture, they had control over the tool they used. Simply like, you know, I am using this stapler. stapler. See, I am using this and I have control over this. In the old world, simply this stapler I am using, okay, I have control over this and I can manage it by my few fingers. And I use this as just an extension of my physical body. This is what happened in the time of Homo habilis. But their tools were placed under their command. Their tools were placed under their command. That is, they had control over the tools they used. Clear? That point is clear. But friends, the problem with technology now is that now tools we possess are not under our command. Same abstract thought. Of course, it is correct. Tools we use these days are not under our command. How many of you believe that the word that is present through this mobile in my hand is under my control? Do you think so? The word that this mobile gives to me is under my control? Or do you think that I am, as a human or as a Homo sapien, is enslaved by this tool, this very tool called mobile? Whether this tool is under my control or whether I am, as a Homo sapien, is being enslaved by this tool? It's a very interesting question, friends. You look around how people live with the tools. Friends, tools now we have are in turn controlling us. We are not controlling the tools. The tools are controlling us. Think of the mobile, as I told you. We are in a sense slave to the mobile. Of course, our ancestors were born with some stone tools. Their hand held some stone tools. But friends, the things have changed. Things have changed. What is happening now? That tools are now controlling us. You think of cars in the old world, you know. You just think of the cars, or you just think of the AI technology or artificial intelligence technology. You just think about transport technology. Friends, nowadays we are not in a position to move or to leave for a few seconds without any of this technology. Just imagine a situation. You see, you have no transportation, you have no AI technology, you have no cars, or you have no mobile. You just imagine that scenario. Friends, you will simply become a non-human then, because our very being of a human, our very existence as a human, is being shaped by the kind of technology we are using. But friends, that was not the way in which our ancestors evolved. Homo habilis. They had control over the tools. which they have used. They could have lived even without tools. They were nomadic. They traveled a lot without any technology. They were bipedal. They were bipedal because they walked on 2 feet. They were bipedal. They never used any transportation technology, and they never required any transportation technology. Their hands were very feet were very powerful. Their legs were very powerful. But friends, that scenario changed now. You see the dangerous proportion technology is coming to our life. And friends, technique as a form, technique as a rational system of thought in the past is analogous to technique in the present. That's what intellectual historians will tell you, that technique as a form in the past is similar to technique as a form in the present. That is, we equate machine tools in the past like, say, dam or irrigation technology or calendar system or architectural technology or civil engineering technology, and we equate those in the past with those in the present, the calendar or the, as I told you, the astronomy, the pottery making, etc., are thought to be same today. Of course, it is right thinking. Technique certainly began with the machine. Technique certainly began with the machine. They were attached to each other. It is quite true that all the rest developed out of machines, that the world developed out of the machines. Meaning that the method by which we make tools are same. In the past, we had a method. In the present, we had a method. And these methods are same by which we use or by which we create tools. And of course, it is also true that without machines, the world of technique would not exist. I should have philosophy of this mobile. How this look like, how it should intervene in my life, how I should use it to engage with the surrounding. That philosophy create this mobile. That is a technique. And that technique create this mobile. Clear. That technique create this mobile. But friends, now something anew happened. Something very different happened. What is it? Technique. When I said technique, I am saying technology. You keep in mind, I am referring to technology when I said technique. Technique has now become almost completely independent of the machine. Earlier, this mobile had a philosophy governing it, which created this mobile. But now, friends, that philosophy which created this mobile is no more connected to this mobile. That is, technique is now independent of the machine which that creates. That is, technique is now applied outside our industrial life. Technique is now applied outside our industrial life. Other areas of life, technique began to get application. At a higher level, technique began to prevail in human life. Once, of course, it was a domain of industry. The tools began to get so much importance in the 19th century. Since the onset of industrial revolution in 18th century, we can see that machines got dominance in human society. But we can say that machines were a product of industrial world. But friends, the problem now we are facing is that other areas of life technique began to get application. Then there is a danger. For example, your cooking, your transportation, your publishing, your social connection with other people. In all these areas, now we began to think about technique in a new way. That is, the monopoly of the industrial world over machines has now disappeared. The power of technique today has no relation to the growing use of machines in everyday life. Today we use machines not only in the industrial life or in the industrial world. Today men or Homo sapiens use machines not only in industrial world. You see, men or Homo sapiens use machines in their sex life, in their reproductive life, in their education life, in their reading habits, in their social relationship. Machines got applications. Many areas of life, machines got wider application, which weren't so in the old world. In the old world, Homo habilis created stone tools just for one purpose, friends. What is it? Just for food. They want to eat meat. They want to cut animal bones. Now just imagine the proportion machines has to advanced over human life. So many areas of our life, machines began to conquer. Now it is the machine or the tool which is now entirely depend upon technology. Machines are now depending technology. In the old world, technology has given shape to machine. And technology was depending upon machine. Now things reversed. Now machines are depending technology. Because technology is a rational thought that comes from our brain. That being stated, today machines which we invent are very conscious. We create machines with a specific purpose. We create machines with a conscious purpose, and it is deployed in specific domains of life with calculated uses. Now tools are made due to technique. That is, technique and its sophistication, technique and its sophistication is more important than the sophistication of machine. We need sophistication in technique, not in machine, because we create machines for a specific purpose, and that purpose is defined by technique. Clear? And the machine represents only a smaller part of technique. Technique is now a ghost. that has made humans a slave. We are all now enslaved by technique. Friends, for example, you are going to characterize the relationship between technique and the machine today. That you could say, not only that the machine is the result of a certain technique, not only that the machine is the result of a certain technique, you have to say that social and economic application of a machine. This mobile was originally created for communication between people, that we want to talk to each other. But friends, now you just look at, most of you are using this mobile as an educational device. That means technique has created this mobile with a specific purpose. And the designers of this mobile has control over the actions that you are going to do. That is to say, social and economic applications of the machines are made possible by other advancements in other areas of life. We can think this way. Machine is now not even the most important aspect of technique. Technique is the most important thing, and machine is not. Technique is important. Friends, this mobile is immaterial, not of any use if there is no technique. There is a philosophy governing this mobile that is very important, which makes this mobile is so important. So this mobile is important because there is a philosophy governing this mobile. That is, we call the technique. And those who have control over that technique will also control our behavior. Clear? I can give you some examples. You may think of Amazon Alexa. And it is capable of voice recognition. You see, now machine is able to recognize your voice. Once you speak, it recognizes it and responds to you. And what if your child trusts the responses of Alexa more than your response? That when your child asks you, "Father, who is the president of the United States?" and you are saying that it is Joe Biden, and your child is not trusting you, it is some bit skeptical of your response, and now your child goes to Alexa and asks Alexa, "Who is the president of United States of America?" And Alexa recognizes the voice of that child and tell you that, "Yes, it is Joe Biden." Yes, the child is happy. And you see, friends, the role of the parent is replaced by Alexa. That is, a machine has replaced the role of the parent. That machine is a consequence of a particular way of rational thinking. Alexa is the consequence of a particular way of rational thinking. Let us say technique. In the same way, Alexa also controls, say, several smart devices using itself as a home automation system. The other day, Alexa, a machine at your home, will grow bigger than your home. That is, friends, it is because technique got a particular way of thinking, and that particular way of thinking produced a particular way of machine. So here, machine is not self-conscious invention, but technique is. Technique is self-conscious, that we create mobile or Alexa, Amazon Alexa, with a specific purpose. From another point of view, friends, machine is deeply symptomatic of a problem. It represents the ideal towards which technique strives. Machine represents the ideal towards which we, the Homo sapiens, would move towards. Technique and the machine hold some kind of special relationship at another level. What is it? That relationship penetrates the very core of our human civilization. That is, machine has created an inhuman atmosphere in our life. That is the problem. Machine has created an inhospitable or inhuman atmosphere in our life. You just imagine about our great cities, the slums, the lack of space in the slums or in the streets or in the cities, lack of air in the city, lack of time in the city, the gloomy streets, the unhappy people walking across the street. You think, just imagine about our dehumanizing factories, our unsatisfied senses, our working women, our detachment from the nature. Life in such an environment has no meaning, friends. Homo habilis just created a simple tool to cut animal bone. That was just for their survival. But friends, now machines created an inhuman world. Consider our public transportation. Friends, today you are traveling by train, you are traveling by, you know, aviation, or you are traveling by ship. You just think that you are just a packet there, not a human being. Your train service consider you not as a human, but just as a thing, a parcel. Look at the communication infrastructure in which I am calling my wife through this mobile. And my calling to my wife is just data. The human is lost in it. The human element is lost. I am just talking to you in this classroom, and in this classroom, we are just data for the machine called my laptop. Consider me as a data, and my voice is data. You are sitting in this classroom and you are attending my lecture, and you give me a heart, but none of this works here. Your listening habit is just data for this laptop technology. Consider our hospitals. You are just a number there. You are not human. You are just number in your hospital, because technology created hospitals as a demon. Consider your internet connection at your home. You are not in the internet. You are just data, just bits. Consider your Kindle app in your mobile, where you used to, which you may use to read books. Friends, your habit of reading in Amazon Kindle is nothing but simply data. You are datafied. Your life is datafied. Consider the Facebook or WhatsApp which you may use for communication with other humans. Friends, where you communicate with your beloved, and you communicate your emotion through Facebook or WhatsApp. But friends, Facebook or WhatsApp don't know whether you are communicating your emotion or not. For them, everything you communicate is just what? Data. But friends, yet we have transportation, we have Kindle, we have great multi-specialty hospitals, we have Facebook and WhatsApp, and yet we say, oh, human society is progressing because technology is progressing. Where is the progress, friends? We are simply numbers and data in that. And human element is lost. yet we say that human society is progressing. This is the real contradiction being created by technique. Machine is antisocial, which was stated by Lewis Mumford in the famous book, The Myth of the Machine. Because its logic of very progress, machine has a logic of progress, and machine is the result of acute form of human exploitation. Machine conquered us. Machine took control of our time. Machine took control of our emotions. Be it a child using an Alexa, or wife talking to a husband over the video call app, or a teacher lecturing in Google Classroom, the social realm is taken over by machine. For that reason, we can presume now that machines created an inhuman society where we are living now. We have let the machines to command us. Machines topples down everything that cannot support its huge load. Machines destroys everything if something stand against it. Now humans have to think everything in terms of machines. That is precisely the role technique plays. We create machines like this because we have a technique behind machine. Machine originally was not in a position to be integrated into human society. Machine was not in a position to be integrated into human society, and it was technique which integrated machines into human society. Technique integrates machines into society and human life. It constructed the kind of world that machine needs. You see, imagine our life has been re-scripted just to make the machines fit to our world. You imagine the direction towards which our world is going, which is directed by technology. That is, now our life is re-scripted in order to make sure that machines fit to our world. Right? So we are being shaped for a machine world. So machines, why do we need it? That is the point. Why do we need it? Of course, humans can't perform well in places where we initially thought we could perform well. That is, we can't run very fast. We can't swim. We can't go underwater. We can't go space. We can't fly. On all these aspects, friends, we need technique. It's not technique, machine. We can't fly, so we need machines. We can't swim into deep water, so we need technique, machine. We can't run fast, so we have to reach at some places in a particular point, particular time period, and considering our speed of the legs, without machines, we can't go there within that particular period of time. So definitely we need some kind of machines. So we have to ask them, is this the beginning of the era of a conscious world? That is, what we created out of machines, is it a conscious world that we are creating? Of course, we are creating a very conscious world. That is, we are creating a conscious world of a conscious mechanized world. We are creating a conscious mechanized world. Friends, all the human elements in our life, all the heart feelings, all the emotional, all the thinking elements, all the sentimental elements, all the human elements in us, that is lost in its place. We have a demon called machines. We consciously design our tomorrow by technique. Technique integrates everything. And man is not, of course, man is not adapted simply to the world of steel. So this steel is meaningless if there is no a specific purpose to this steel. And who gives a purpose to this steel? It is given by technique. So our world is being, you know, increasingly taken over by the technique behind this steel. But friends, thus technique creates means. Technique creates means. The skilled worker, like the primitive huntsman, remains a technical operator. The point is that only their attitude differs. That skilled worker in the modern day, their attitude is different from that of the primitive hunting man. And reason, that is part of the technique, human reason, that is part of the technique, which makes it possible to produce objects. Technique produce objects in terms of certain features, certain abstract requirements. And this is an intervention of our consciousness, that we design machines by consciousness, and that consciousness is being filled by technique. In fact, friends, nothing escapes technique today. There is no field in human society that is outside technique. Technique is so much dominant in our life. We are habituated to machines because of technique. Nothing is left there. In simple sense, friends, we can say that technology, or otherwise called technique, is a philosophy underpinning the machine. It gives life to immaterial objects. Thereby, machines attain life forms. Technique is a rational way of building the world. Like an ideology, like theology, like archaeology, or like biology. Technology is like a religion, a dominating religion, without any alternative at all. It's a philosophy that governs our very existence. A rational system of thought. It's a way of doing. Technology is a way of doing. A way of resolving. A resolution. A rational action. A calculated use of action to attain desired objects. And machines are its anchor. Machines are the anchors of technique. Technique attaches machines to human life. It's a way of organizing life. A way of organizing life. Technology gives us what machines alone cannot give us. Friends, if you think you need an AI doctor, for example, technology designed a new way of healthcare social system. It replaces the old healthcare in which human physician attained primacy. Just like Homo habilis controlled their tools, or the Neolithic people controlled their tools, a physician in the traditional healthcare system controlled the code of health system. But friends, when you are coming through AI doctor, artificial intelligence doctor, the whole social system of healthcare changes. Here, technology reigning. AI doctor is just the machine that comes, we think so, to our help, but that is not true. AI doctor is not going to help you. The whole philosophy underpinning the AI doctor is a technique, a new worldview in which machines replace the human world. Think about your autonomous cars. Think about your drone delivery system. Think about your smart homes. Think about your smart cities or artificial intelligence refrigerator or your artificial intelligence air conditioner. These things, these machines replace your old roles, the old roles of humans and their interactions with the old machines. The cars that you have driven in the old world is because of your human judgment that you are using the steering and you are raising the pedaling the accelerator, you are pedaling the clutch, you are pedaling the brake, all because of your human judgment. That was a brainy activity. Your driving was a brainy activity. What if that driver is replaced by an AI driver, an artificial intelligence driver? Friends, in the old world, your cars are driven by human judgment. Your refrigerators are managed by human calculations. So in the past, man or the postman or the parcel delivery boy, they were all humans. But in the new scenario of machines ruling the world because of a technique, AI-enabled machines are more than machines. AI-enabled machines are more than the humans. And your machines are now bigger than humans because they are governing us by a technique. And that technique governs our future. It rationalizes our future action. It sets out how the world needs to be worked upon in the future. And we are controlled by technique. We are taken over by its instrument called a machine. Friends, our age is passing from a primitive state of man. The old world, man's interaction with the tools and weapons were primarily for the purpose of achieving some kind of control over nature. But now man is radically different. Now we are living in a radically different condition. Man is not conquering the nature, but man is detached from the nature. That is a problem. In the old world, technology we use just to conquer the nature. But now, friends, machines has detached man from the nature as much possible. And we are taken away from our organic habitat. It is a dangerous scenario, friends. The Homo habilis is replaced. The tool man is replaced. Tools become now a dominant philosophy. Now tools are a dominant philosophy governing us. A new religion. Now technology is a new religion. So friends, how we lost to technology is an interesting question. And it's an intriguing question. And to answer this, we need to look at how technology evolved in the ancient Greece, in the ancient Rome, in the medieval Christianity, in the Enlightenment era, in the industrial world, as well as in the post-industrial world. We have to look at the history of technology, and thereby we can understand how Homo sapiens were lost to technology, and how technology became a new religion. That we will discuss in the next lecture. Friends, now the floor is open for discussion. Yes, friends.